बर्नौलीज थ्योरम आ जाएगा, लेकिन आंसर आएगा बर्नौलीज थ्योरम से करना अपने को बराबर। इट इज रिवॉल्व बिकॉज व्हेन यू रिवॉल्व, हाइट का डिफरेंस मतलब प्रेशर से रिलेटेड है। रिवॉल्व बिटवीन एज एंड सेंटर, एक मिनट डायग्राम बना के तो समझेगा, तो अलग ऐसा है। तो जैसे सिलेंडर एक्सिस, देन यू स्टार्ट रोटेटिंग, देन डिफरेंस एट सेंटर एंड एज इन द हाइट इज सपोज एज, दिस इज वॉट विच वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट एंड दिस रोटेटेड विथ ओमेगा। You are telling Bernoulli's principle we have to use. If this is A and this point is B, both are at same height.
Yes.
Same height. So can we say at same height, that is A and B are in same point, pressure at A minus pressure at B is half of rho, velocity at B square minus velocity at A square at same height. At A, liquid lies on the axis, so velocity is zero. So PA minus PB will be half velocity at B square minus zero, because omega, V is R omega, R is from the axis zero. Now difference in the pressure at the two point A and B is equals to height H into density of liquid rho into G. This is half rho. Velocity is r omega square. So I can say r square. V is r omega. So r square omega square. Anything we can cancel from both sides? Rho we can cancel. So 2 h g upon r square is omega square. This I wrote by Bernoulli's principle. Yes, you have not written test. Hello, yes.
Yes, sir.
Test you have written?
Yes, sir. Wait, I will send it.
The test when you are supposed to do?
Sorry, sir, I forgot to send it. I will send it now.
Monday over, Tuesday over, Wednesday over, today is Thursday, and you forgot you are saying. So very difficult to keep eye watch on all this, huh? You have to be honest with your work. Send now.
Sir, send it.
Okay.
Done, sir.
Yes, got it, huh? Sum number 64. The liquid of mercury rho flows along horizontal pipe of uniform area of cross section A. Liquid of density rho flows through horizontal pipe of area A. Horizontal pipe of area A, liquid of density rho. With velocity V. With velocity V. Through right angle bend. Through right angle bend. Right angle bend. What force is applied to the bend to hold it in equilibrium? What is force applied at the bend to hold at equilibrium? What is force applied at the bend to hold it under equilibrium? So this liquid is coming here and applying force, then going here. So net will be perpendicular. Pythagoras theorem, correct? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So mass of liquid flowing, what is force applied? Do we know mass of liquid flowing per second? Can we find mass of liquid flowing per second? Mass of liquid per second. And velocity is constant because area is same. So mass of liquid is nothing but density into volume per second. Volume per second is area into distance per second. Distance per second is called velocity. Correct? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Mass of liquid flowing per second is nothing but rho AV. Just write this one. Hello? Yeah? How many? Zoom. नहीं मैं आपको भेजूंगा ये नंबर पे भेजना है ओके वो आज नहीं कर पाएंगे मैडम आज नहीं कर पाएंगे क्योंकि आज फर्स्ट लेक्चर है ना कुछ तो पहला मुझे इंटरेक्ट करना पड़ेगा और टेस्ट नेक्स्ट लेक्चर से स्टार्ट करेगा So rho into A into V is nothing but mass of liquid flowing per second. So if I want force, can I find change in momentum? Hello?
Yes, sir.
जो लोग ने बोला इट इज फ्लोइंग थ्रू बेंड एट राइट एंगल मतलब ऐसा आके ऐसा जा रहा है ना तो इधर जो भी मोमेंटम आएगा इधर जो भी मोमेंटम आएगा वो दोनों मोमेंटम सेम रहने वाला है बिकॉज़ मास सेम है वेलोसिटी सेम है बट रिजल्टेंट विल बी पाइथागोरस थ्योरम करेक्ट हेलो
यस सर
सो नेट चेंज थोड़ा डिफिकल्ट समय इन मोमेंटम We didn't by went by pressure because P1 minus P2 इधर height में कुछ फर्क पता नहीं ना कितना height है, so we cannot find h rho g, इसलिए mass से गए, so net change in momentum, comma delta P is nothing but root of P1 square plus P2 square, where P is momentum here, that means both are same, so I can say root 2 times P1 square. Which is root 2 times P1. that is root 2 times mass into velocity. Mass into velocity. So net force exerted is change in momentum per unit time. Change in momentum is root 2 mv upon time t. Now mass per unit time we know. Mass per unit time is root av into v. So root 2 rho av square will be net force exerted. That is option C. Very, very important sum. Today only you practice all this sum. Don't do extra, but at least what is done, that you practice. And remaining time, practice modern physics for the test.
Done, sir.
65th theoretical one. See, whenever there is aerodynamic lift or called dynamic lift, then through that either you consider a ball or span of aeroplane, the flow स्ट्रीमलाइन इज नॉट सेम थ्रू आउट. ऊपर ज्यादा नीचे कम रहता है. ऊपर वेलोसिटी ज्यादा मतलब प्रेशर कम. नीचे का प्रेशर ज्यादा होता है, सो इट गेट्स लिफ्टेड. दैट इज कॉल्ड एरो लिफ्ट और डायनेमिक लिफ्ट. सो दे आर सेइंग फॉर क्रिकेट बॉल दैट इज स्पिनिंग क्लॉकवाइज इन एयर. ऐसा स्पिन हो रहा है क्लॉकवाइज इन एयर. स्पिनिंग क्लॉकवाइज इन एयर, वॉट विल बी द effect, which one is correct? So because it is spinning in clockwise direction, due to spin, upper speed jyada hai iska. So here the pressure is less, speed is more. Here speed is less, pressure is less, pressure is more. So it gets lifted. So streamline of air is symmetric? No. Upward it is more, downward it will be less. The velocity of air above the ball relative to larger than that below. Yes, relative velocity upar jada, right? Velocity of air above is small or wrong? There is net upward force on the ball. Yes. So B is correct because ये velocity ज़्यादा net upward force इससे baller जब भी ball करता है तो ये directly ऊपर turn हो जाता है. So there is option B is correct. 66. 66. A tank full of water has a small hole at its bottom. Small hole at its bottom. If 1/4 of the tank is emptied in t1 second, 1/4 is emptied in t1 second. And remaining 3/4 is emptied in how much? In t2 second. Ratio of t1 to t2 we have to find. Is it like an orifice sum? There is hole at the bottom. Hello?
Yes, sir.
This is area of cross section of tank and this is suppose area of cross section of hole. Throughout mass is not same because jaise se water kam hoega upar se force kam hoega, upar se force kam hoega to acceleration of water change hoega. So here acceleration of water is not constant, so I can say the water level is reducing. That is, height with respect to time is decreasing. Height with respect to time is decreasing. But area is constant. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Velocity through an orifice at any given instant is 2ah in root. Velocity. Velocity into this area is called as volume. अच्छा पहले इतना तो करो फिर मैं समझाता हूं. जस्ट कंप्लीट ओनली टिल दिस. Mass reducing is nothing but mass overflowing. Mass reducing per unit time equal to mass flowing out per unit time. Just copy this much. Yes, can I clear?
Yes, sir.
You want what is time taken to reduce 1/4 and time taken to reduce kitna full bola kya tum, what is t1 given? T1 is the time taken to reduce from where to where. T1 is the time to reduce by 1/4, na? Hello.
Yes, sir.
T1 is the time to reduce 1/4, and what is t2? T2, what is T2? The remaining three emptied matlab zero ho jata hai na baad mein. So it is like this. See, first we said mass reducing is same as mass coming out. Mass is density into volume of volume of water in cylinder. Density, volume of water pouring out. Mass is density into volume. Per unit time, density will get cancelled. Volume is area into distance, which is reducing at the rate of dh by dt. Reducing, therefore we can write minus. This is decreasing, and here it is area of base into distance upon time is called velocity, which is root of 2gh. So from this we can say dt equals to minus a dh upon a root of 2gh, that is minus a upon a root 2g dh upon h. This all are constant. So now ratio of time for first to the second will be equals to integration of minus a upon 2 root g dh upon h divided by same minus a upon root 2 g dh upon h, dh upon root h, root h, root h, root h. This is constant, so I can cancel. But here height is changing from total height h to 3/4, because 1/4 is empty, left out is 3h/4. Then from 3h/4 it becomes zero. This is limit of integration. So equals to integration of root h. What is integration of root h? H raised to minus half integration, minus half h raised to minus half, sorry, minus half plus no, yes sir, ha say no problem sir. It's open till 3:30, madam. Yeah. Tomorrow, sir, there is no guarantee. Today, the person came. ठीक है ठीक है. Tomorrow, I will ask him. I will drop the message. I will drop the message at 10:30. Yes, yes. 10:30 comes. Yes. So when I send the message, then you start from your place. Okay. Haan, actually I've got lecture. No problem, you tell so many. I will call you at around 1:45. Yeah. Okay. Hello. What is integration of root of h? Any idea? Integration of root of h. Okay, just copy till this first. Then we'll see what. Just copy till this. Today only please practice all sums. In fact, each sum if you practice three times, then you'll understand the concept.
Done, sir.
Okay. Everybody has done? Then I'm explaining integration of root h. Yes, you want me to bring it back or everybody has copied?
Done, sir.
Copied, na?
Yes.
Now, integration of root of h is same as h raised to minus half. That will become h raised to minus half plus 1 divided by this total. That is nothing but half. So it becomes h raised to half upon half. That is nothing but you will get 2 times root of h. Okay. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Therefore, our t1 upon t2, the final answer will be root h. This also root h. Limit of integrations are different. This is from h to 3h by 4 and this is from 3h by 4 becoming 0. So this will become root of 3h by 4 minus root of h divided by root of upper limit is 0. So it is 0 minus of root of 3h by 4. That will become root 3h by 4 minus root h. Can we simplify this? This is like root 3h upon 2 minus root h upon minus of root 3h by 4 you can write as 2. So this is root 3 into root 3 by 2, root 3 into h by 2 minus of root h. Root 3 into root h minus root h upon minus of root 3 into root h upon 2. Now how to simplify it? This I cross multiply, I will get root 3 root h minus 2 root h you can consider as 4. So root 3 h minus of root 4 h upon 2 minus of root 3 into root h upon 2. This is cancelled. 2. Just copy this much, space is not there, then I'm simplifying. Root h root 3 minus 2 upon minus of root 3 root h. This will get cancelled. So we can write minus of 2 minus root 3 upon minus root 3. This gets cancelled. So final answer will be minus root 3 upon root 3. That is option. Yes, done. Hello, done.
Yes, sir.
Please practice once again. Same, some practice again. Yes, practice again.
Yes, sir.
Come to 67. A container of height 10 meter. Container of height 10 meter, which is open at the top, has water to its full height. Yes. Water is up to full height, 10 meter. Two small openings are made on the wall of container, one exactly at the middle and other at the bottom. One at the middle means at h by 2 and other is at bottom means at height h. The ratio of velocity coming out from the middle and the from the middle, and that height h will be how much? Velocity coming out is root 2 gh formula. So first velocity upon second velocity is root 2 g h by 2 upon root 2 times h. So root 2 cancel. This will be equals to root h upon root 2 into 1 upon root h. So equals to 1 by root 2 is the required. One by root two. Okay. Water is in streamline flow along horizontal pipe. Water is in streamline flow along horizontal pipe with non-uniform cross section. At a point in a pipe where area is 10, velocity is 1 and pressure is 20,000. Pressure at another point, at one point they have given area 10, velocity, this is larger side, area 10, area second one is a 5 centimeter square, 10 centimeter square. Velocity is here 10 meter per second and pressure is 2000 Pascal. The pressure at another point where area is 5 will be how much? Is the question. See, first with A1, B1, I can get A2, say V2. A1, B1 is A2, V2 for streamline flow. So 10 into 10 is 5 into V2. 5 into 2 is 10. Therefore, V2 is 10. 20. Okay. Now P1 minus P2 is half rho V2 square minus V1 square. First pressure is 2000. Second pressure we want half rho V2 square. Rho means, is it water given? Yes. So water in SI unit is 10 raised to 3. And velocity V2 is 20 square minus V1, 10 square. So this will become 2000 minus P2 is half into 10 raised to 3, 400 minus 100 is 300. Therefore, 2000 minus P2, this is 10 raised to 3 means 1000 upon 2. 1000 into 300 upon 2, 2 into 500. 5 centimeter square, 10 centimeter square, velocity V2 is 20, 400 minus 1, pressure is given in Pascal. So we are getting this as velocity. Velocity is given as 1, sorry, I made mistake. This is 1. Velocity is 1, so it will become 2. Therefore, this will become 2 square, okay, 3. So 1000, that means it is 1500. Therefore, pressure P2 is 2000 minus 1500 equal to 500 Pascal. That is nothing but P. Yes, completed 68.
Yes, sir.
69. Water flows steadily through horizontal pipe of cross section, variable cross section. If the pressure of water is rho at a point where velocity is V, pressure P, velocity V. What is pressure at another point where velocity is 2V? Velocity is 2V. Pressure is question mark. Rho is the density of water. Okay. So we know V1, we know V2. Now P1 minus P2 is half rho V2 square minus V1 square. P1 is P, P2 we want half rho, V2 is 2V. So it will become 4V square minus V square. So P minus P2 is half rho into 3V square. Therefore, P2 is P plus half rho. P2 equals to P minus half rho 3V square. P minus half rho 3V square by 2. That is option D. Yes, John. Hello, completed?
Yes, sir.
Yes. 70 and 71 are theoretical. Working of Venturi meter is based on Bernoulli's principle. That is option C. 70 option is C, Bernoulli's principle. 71. In old age arteries carrying blood in human body becomes narrow, resulting in increase in blood pressure. This follows from Bernoulli's principle. Again, C. Next one, 72. A gas bubble of 2 cm diameter rises through a liquid of density 1.75. with fixed speed means with constant speed. The density of gas will be how much if coefficient of viscosity of liquid is given? Since bubble is rising with constant speed, that is terminal velocity wala case. Terminal velocity. So V equals to 2R square G upon 9 eta, because it is rising. Air gas bubble is rising. In the gas bubble of this much space, neglect the density of gas. What is the coefficient rising through the liquid? Rising through the liquid means liquid is heavier and that bubble is lighter. So it is always heavier minus lighter. Velocity is given as 0.35. The poise is nothing but SI unit. That is called poise. Newton second per meter square is SI unit. That is called poise for coefficient of viscosity. So 2 into R. R means half of diameter. So 1 centimeter, that means 10 raised to minus 2 meter square. G, not given, we will take 10. Density of liquid, 1.75 gram per centimeter cube. So it is into 10 raised to 3 kg per meter cube. Neglect the density of the bubble upon 9 times eta. So eta equals to 2 into 10 raised to minus 4 into 10 into 1.75 into 10 raised to 3 upon 9 into 0.35. So this will be 2 into 5. This we can cancel by 5. 2 into 175 into 10 raised to minus 3 plus 3 ke saath cancel. 10 raised to minus 2. 9 into 35 into 10 raised to minus 2 ye bhi cancel. Rest all values are same. 1.75 into 10 raised to 3. 0.35 centimeter. So into 10 raised to minus 2, 10 raised to minus 2, 10 raised to minus 2 extra. So 5 5s are 15 and 2 17, so it is 5. So we get 10 upon 9 into 10 raised to 2. 9 into 1 will be, if zero ka koi problem to nahi hai, just check it. One square into this much, 1.758.
Yeah, unit ka khali problem hai. Okay?
To R square G upon 9 eta. All values are given in CGS. First I am finding in CGS, then converting. Eta will become 2R square G upon 9V rho of liquid minus rho of bubble. That is 2 into 1 square into G, we can take 980 in CGS. Rho of liquid is given 1.75. Other one we have to neglect, upon 9 into velocity is 0.5. That will become 0.35 into 7. 7 into 2 is 14 into 980 upon 9. This is nearly 9 into 1 is 9, 0, 9, 9 is 81. So 109 into 14 approximately. That will come out to be 109 into 14. Nine into one is nine, zero nine means 81.
this error. 3 × 1.75 × 35, 75 = 30, sorry, 5.
So 5 into 2 is 1090. Voice is CGS unit. 1090. Do we have close to this 1090?
Yes, sir. Option D. 1089.
Option D. So voice is actually CGS.
वॉइस इज एक्चुअली ऐसा यूनिट, वो लोग ने कुछ गड़बड़ कर दिया है. वॉइस जो दिया है ना सीजीएस करके, कुछ तो मिस्टेक है, बट वैल्यू इज सेम. कैलकुलेशन डन.
यस सर.
सम नंबर 73, 74 are theoretical. Viscous force of the liquid. Viscous force exerted by the liquid flowing between two plates in a streamlined flow depends upon velocity gradient, area, coefficient of viscosity, all of the three. So option D. It depends upon all. Eta A dV by dx. Solid sphere with terminal velocity of 20 meter per second in air, if it is allowed to fall in vacuum, what will happen? If it is allowed to fall in vacuum, what is vacuum? Is there any particle present?
No, sir.
That means there is no viscous drag or viscous force. Huh? To have viscous force, we require 6 pi eta r v. And to have v, we require velocity. So because it is allowed to fall in vacuum, that means there is no fluid in this. If there is no fluid, we can't talk about terminal velocity. So we will say there will be no terminal velocity as such. There will be no terminal velocity. Because there is no viscous drag in the vacuum. So there is no terminal velocity. A solid ball of volume V experiences viscous force F when falling with speed V in a liquid. If another ball of volume V1, volume is V, force is F, and falling with speed V1 is V. If another ball of volume A2V is falling with same speed, in same liquid, what is the viscous force F2? Now, viscous force when body is rising or falling is 6 pi eta RV. So, F1 upon F2 is equals to R1 upon R2 V1 upon V2.
Now volume V1 upon V2 is R1 upon R2 cube. Therefore V upon A to V is R1 upon R2 cube. Therefore 1 by 2 is R1 by R2. Therefore F1 upon F2 will become 1 by 2. Velocity is same they are telling. So F2 equals to 2 times F1. 2 times F1 option E. This is also standard sum. Okay, completed.
Yes, sir.
Next one. 76. A small metal sphere of radius A is falling with velocity V through a vertical column of viscous fluid. Coefficient is eta. Then sphere encounters an opposing force. Opposing force means viscous force. Encounters opposing force as 6 pi eta rv. R is A into V. Encounters opposing force 6 pi eta rv. That is option C. 77. Two sphere are of same material. So rho 1 is same as rho 2. Radius R1 is R and R2 is 3R. Allowed to fall vertically downward to liquid of same density. Rho is same. Rho 1 is same as rho 2 is same as rho. What is ratio of terminal velocity? Terminal velocity is 2r square g upon 9 eta rho minus sigma here. Everything is same in this case except the radius. So v1 upon v2 is r1 upon r2 square. Therefore v1 upon v2 is r upon 3r the whole square. Therefore v1 upon v2 is 1 upon 9. 1:9 options. Yes, completed.
यस सर।
A spherical body of diameter d is falling in the viscous medium. Then terminal velocity is. Terminal velocity is 2 r square g upon 9 theta rho minus 0. Therefore, v is proportional to r square. That is v proportional to diameter square. Option C. Right. 79. Terminal velocity attained by aluminium falling through sphere of radius 1 falling through water at 20 will be close to how much if flow is streamlined, specific gravity of aluminium is 2.7 and coefficient of viscosity is 8 into 10 raised to minus 4. 8 into 10 raised to minus 4 pi is nothing but it is called as poise ke liye pi bhi likhte the kabhi kabhi. Now we know terminal velocity v is 2 r square g upon 9 eta rho of solid minus rho of liquid. So 2 into r is 1 millimeter 10 raised to minus 3 square into g 9.8 into specific gravity 2.7. That means density is 2.7 into density of water minus 10 raised to 3 upon 9. See, specific gravity means density of solid upon density of water is called specific. Upon 9 eta is 8 into 10 raised to minus 4. 2 into 4 is 8. So it is 9.8 into 10 raised to minus 6 into 2.7 minus 1 is 1.7 into 10 raised to 3 upon 9 into 4 into 10 raised to minus 4 goes up plus 4. Roughly we can say 4 into 0.4 is 1.6. 9 into 1 is 9. 9 9s are 81. 1.9 into 0.4 into 10 raised to minus 1. It will become 19 into 4. 4 is 16. 4 into 0.4, 71, that's plus 1. 4 into 9, 36. 0.76 into 10 raised to 1. 7.6, take your option.
नो सर।
हाँ नहीं है?
नहीं
कुछ कैलकुलेशन एरर है क्या? देख लेते एक बार पता कर। टू इनटू 10 रेज टू माइनस 3 स्क्वायर इनटू 2.7 10 रेज टू क्यूब 10 रेज टू 3 इस में 2.7 दिस इज 1.7 बराबर है 10 रेज टू 3 10 raised to 2 minus 4 power 4, 9, 8. 2 into 4 is 8. So 9.8 into 4, 1.7, whatever. Into 10 raised to 3, 10 raised to 4, 2 4 is 8, 4 4 is 16. 9 into 1 is 9, 9 is 0, I don't know. 0 and then 9, 9 is 81. So it will be
4 into 9, 36. One point zero nine into this, so it will become actually 1.09 into 4. 4.36 के आसपास में है. Yes, 4.36 के आसपास में means 4.6 you can take. C is the answer. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Tomorrow morning, as usual, as we keep, is it okay? 8:30. कल Friday हम लोग last time के क्या रखते थे? 9 to 10 ना?
9 o'clock.
So is it okay? 9 o'clock tomorrow?
Yes.
Sir, 8:30 would
be good.
8:30 चाहिए?
Yes, sir. क्योंकि 10 से class है.
पहले 8:30 से क्लास है आपका.